This video tutorial I will explain JMS API programming model. Here you can see the basic building blocks of JMS application, administrated objects like connection factories and destinations, connections, sessions, message producers, message consumers, and messages. Using connection factory, we can create a connection. Using connection, we can create a session. Using session, we can create a message. Using session, we can create a message producer. Using message producer, we can send message to the destination. Using session, we can create a message consumer. Message consumer is used to consume a message from destination. Using JMS, the applications can communicate with each other by sending and receiving messages. There are various JMS providers are available in the market which implements JMS standard. Examples of JMS providers are Apache ActiveMQ, IBM WebSphere MQ, JBoss Hornet Q, etc. Connection factory is the object which client uses to create connection to the provider. Connection factory encapsulates set of connection parameters. These connection parameters has been defined by the administrator. And each connection factory is an instance of connection factory or queue connection factory or topic connection factory interface. There are two types of JMS destinations are there. The first one is queue and the second one is topics. The message producer send message to the destination and message consumer consume message from the destination. JMS connections. A connection encapsulates a virtual connection with a JMS provider. A connection could represent an open TCP/IP socket between a client and the provider service daemon. And we can use connection to create one or more sessions. Session is a single-threaded context for producing and consuming messages. Using sessions, we can create message producers, message consumers, messages, queue browsers, and temporary queues and topics. Message producer is an object that is created by a session. Using message producer, we can send message to the destination. Message producer implements message producer interface. Message consumer is an object that is created by a session. Using message consumer, we can consume message from the destination. Message consumer implements message consumer interface. JMS message listeners. A message listener is an object that acts as an asynchronous event handler for messages. Message listener object implements message listener interface. It has one method called onMessage. In that method, we have to define what kind of action we have to take when message arrives. And we can register the message listener with message consumer by calling setMessageListener method. Using message selectors, the message consumer can specify what kind of message the message consumer is interested in and what kind of message the message consumer wants to consume. Using a queue browser object, we can inspect the message in the queue. There are two kinds of delivery modes are there. The first one is persistent, second one is non-persistent. If delivery mode is persistent, it means messages will be stored on disk or database until messages are consumed by the consumer. And messages will survive a broker restart. In case of non-persistent delivery mode, if we kill the broker, we will lose all the in-transit messages. In case of topics, there are two subscriptions are there. The first one is durable subscription and second one is non-durable subscription. In case of durable subscription, if the subscriber is down for some time, and after some point of time, the subscriber is coming up. then it will receive all the messages which was sent to it, including the messages which was sent during the downtime. In case of a non-durable subscription, the subscriber will receive only the messages when it was connected to the topic. Suppose a subscriber is down for some time, in that time some messages are sent, then after subscriber coming back, it won't receive the messages when it was down. So it will lose all the messages when it was down. You can get a Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.